Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain you about complex power series. What is complex power series? So, a series which is in the form of summation an z power n is called the complex power series. So to explain this, I will take an example. So, that is 1 plus z square plus z cube plus so on. So this is one type of series. So if you observe here 1 plus z, here z square, z cube, so on means z power 4, z power 5. So this is called the series. This series should be written in this form. So this example series can be written as summation n is equal to 0 to infinity z power n. So how means? Summation means instead of all these pluses, I mentioned summation. And here n is equal to 0 up to infinity means here in this first term you will get n is equal to 0, in next term you will get n is equals to 1, in this term you will get n is equals to 2, here n is equal to 3. So this process will be go on like this. For example, if you consider n is equal to 0, so z power n also 0, z power 0 is 1, so here you will get 1. In next condition you will get n is equals to 1, so z power n means 1, so that is z, so this is z. In next condition n is equals to 2, z power n means z power 2, that is z square, so here z square. So up to n is equals to infinity you will get some values. So this series can be written in this form, summation n is equal to 0 to infinity z power n. So this is the series. Here why I taken this z power n means, so if you observe in this series z, so in all the terms we are having z value is the common, so I taken here z. So the changing is powers, here 1, here 2, here 3, next 4, next 5, so that I considered as n, so z power n. So I hope you understand this. And in complex power series we are having Taylor's series and Lorentz series. So in this video I will explain Taylor's series. This is the question, expand log z by using Taylor's series at z is equals to 1. So this is f of z is equals to log z. So here z is equals to 1, this should be written in this z minus a form. So this one should move to this side, that means LHS side. So z minus 1 you will get. So in place of a we are having 1, that means a is equals to 1. Again, Taylor series formula is f of z is equals to f of a plus z minus a f dash of a by 1 factorial plus z minus a whole square f double dash of a by 2 factorial plus z minus a whole cube f triple dash of a by 3 factorial plus so on. So this is the formula for Taylor series. So here we need to find f of a value, f dash of a value, f double dash of a value and f triple dash of a value. Here to find f of a value, first of all we need to find f of z. So here we already know f of z is equals to log z. So from this f of a we need to find. So a means 1, f of 1. So 1 means in place of z we have to put 1. So here log 1, that will be 0. So and to find f dash of a, first we need to find f dash of z. So f dash of z. So f dash of z means d by dz of this log z. So you will get 1 by z. From this we need to find f dash of a, that means f dash of 1. So f dash of 1 means wherever you are having z, there we have to put 1. So 1 by 1 is equals to 1. And then we need to find f double dash of a. To find f double dash of a we need to find f double dash of z. So f double dash of z, that means d by dz of this term, 1 by z. 1 by z can be written as z power minus 1. So d by dz of z power minus 1 means it is in the form of d by dx of x power n. So it is in the form of d by dx of x power n. So n into x power n minus 1 we have to write. So in this formula, so minus 1 z power minus 1 minus 1. So you will get minus 1 z power minus 2. So this is the answer for f double dash of z. So from these we need to find f double dash of a, that means f double dash of 1. So 1 means wherever you are having z, we have to put 1. So minus 1 and 1 for minus 2. Here you will get minus 1. So solve this in calci. So minus 1. So here again we need to find f triple dash of z. So f triple dash of means d by dz of this value. So minus 1 z power minus 2. So here minus 1 is constant, minus 1 d by dz of z power minus 2. Again this is in the form of d by dx of x power n. So this can be written as this minus 1, and here d by dz of z minus 2 means minus 2 z power minus 2 minus 1. So here you will get 2 z power minus 3. So again from this you need to find f triple dash. This is triple dash of a, that means f triple dash of 1. So wherever you are having z, there we have to put 1. 2 into 1 power minus 3. Here you will get 2. So f triple dash of a means 2. So from this f of a, f dash of a, f double dash of a, f triple dash of a. So these all values we know now. So substitute there. So f of z is equals to f of a means 0 plus z minus a means 1. And f dash of a means again 1 by 1 factorial plus into z minus a, z minus a means 1 whole square, and again here f double dash of a value is minus 1. So here you will get minus 1 by 2 factorial plus z minus 1 whole cube, f triple dash of a value is 2 into 2 by 3 factorial plus so on. Here 3 factorial means 6, right? So 2 1s are 2 3s are. Here you will get 3. And here minus into plus minus. This can be written as f of z is equals to z minus 1. So 1 factorial means again 1. Here minus into plus means minus. Minus z minus 1 whole square by 2. And again plus z minus 1 whole cube by 3. Plus so on. So this is the answer. So we had expanded log z at z is equals to 1 by using Taylor series. Next video we will solve another problem on Taylor series.